So the other day I was going through my comment section and I saw a great suggestion from Klaus Beckman, who was like, hey bro, why don't you do a video on Chrome Inspector? And I was like, that's a great idea, because it's a tool that I use all the time in my own workflow and I sort of take it for granted. So I just wanted to give you a brief overview of how this tool works, where all the most important features are located, and how to start using it in your own website development. All right, let's get started. Once you're in Chrome and you have a page you'd like to inspect, there's a couple ways to open the inspector. One is to right-click on an element that you'd like to inspect and then just choose Inspect from the context menu. You can also use a keyboard shortcut, and some pages actually disable right-click by using JavaScript, so you can just hit F12 on Windows to open the inspector. You can also use the shortcut Control-Shift-I on Windows, or I believe it would be Command-Option-I on Mac. So this is the basic inspector or DevTools window, and you can actually reposition this to better fit your workflow. For example, a lot of people like to anchor it to the side of the screen so they have more vertical space. To reposition your DevTools, you right-click these three dots here, and you can choose a dock location. So you could do left, right, for example, right here, or you could even pop it out as a separate box, and then you have the entire screen to work with. But I'm just going to pop it into the right side, and you can probably see that the text is quite small, and if you're on a mobile screen, you're going to have trouble reading this. But if you select inside this box here, you can use keyboard shortcuts like Control++ or Control-, to change the text size. So just to start, let me dock this to the bottom so I can better show you all the panels that we have to work with here. Now, when you're doing CSS, you're mostly gonna be in the Elements panel here, and this gives you a full view of the HTML document, and you can also see the styles that apply to any element on the other side. So if I just inspect here, we can see all the styles over here that apply to this paragraph element. And there's other tabs here. There's the console for JavaScript. There's sources that show all the files that are being loaded by the page. There's the network tab for speed testing that also goes hand in hand with the performance tab. The memory, application, and security tabs are pretty much only going to be used by professional developers. And then there's a dedicated lighthouse testing tool if you really want to dive deep into speed testing your site and making sure it's optimized for Google's new page experience algorithm. But for this tutorial, we're going to be sticking exclusively in the Elements panel here. And there's two views that you're going to use most. There's the Styles tab where we can see the actual rules that have been written. And then there's the Computed tab, which shows you all the rules that are actually being applied to any element. So this is a really short and quick way to find, for example, what font family or what color an element is. And then to see the rule that's actually creating this property, we can just click the tab here. And then you can click this arrow, and it will take you to the exact rule in the Style tab that is setting the style. Now, you can do more than just look at the styles that are being applied to an element. You can actually write styles directly in the browser. So you can use this element.style, which we'll have for any element, and these rules will be applied to only that exact element. So for example, I can make the background color hot pink for this one paragraph. I'll just turn that rule off for now. You can also create new rules. So you could target an element, click the plus icon here, and it will create a new rule for any paragraph element. So we can make them all background color pink. And you can add your own custom selectors here. So for example, if you want it only to be the first paragraph in the document, okay? And you can add any number of classes or IDs playing around the browser. Now there's one thing to note, and that is, if you refresh the page, you're going to lose any customizations that you've made here. So what you want to do is you can make your customizations and play around. And it's kind of nice to do some tweaks in DevTools because it actually helps you autocomplete your code. And it's always going to help you get the syntax right. So for example, sometimes I forget how to properly do gradients. But I can say, if I just start typing linear gradient, it's going to show me the basic format here. And I can just hit tab to complete that. And then I can tweak these styles. So I can adjust the angle. I can change the color. Okay. So that makes it a lot easier. You're almost designing visually. And then once you've got all your styles saved, you've made your page look how you want it to look, you can click to go to the Inspector style sheet. And you can just copy all these styles and either put them in a notepad or put them directly in your website to save them for later. Just know that if we do refresh the page, all your changes are going to be lost. Now, as you saw, you can toggle styles on and off. So if I inspect this element here, and say I want to disable one of the rules, like the background color, I can just toggle this off by unchecking it. And now it goes back to the default background color, which was here. And I can disable that one as well. And now it has a transparent background. And that can be useful for troubleshooting problems if you're not sure which rules. Sometimes there'll be multiple rules that are applying to an element. And if you're troubleshooting to find out which rule is actually causing the style, that's one way to do it. And again, the other way to do it is go to the computer tab and then click through to see which rule is actually setting the property. Now let's go back to the computer tab for a second. And I'm going to show you some handy features that are in here. And one is this box model sort of view at the top. And what this does is for any element, if you select it by clicking on the source code here, it shows you the width and the height of that exact element. It shows you all the padding. And if you hover over the element, the padding is always green. So you can see the padding there. And then it shows you the border as orange. And it shows you the margin as a different color orange, but it shows you the values for all these spacing properties for your element. And you can adjust them in real time. So you can double click and we could just get rid of the left margin, for example, and it would move over. We could get rid of the padding at the top or make it really big, like 150 pixels of padding at the top. You can play around with these values. So it makes it really easy to see what's affecting the spacing on your element, but also to find the right element to target. So sometimes there'll be like an inner box. And maybe you thought that it was this that had the spacing on it, but you can see that there's actually no spacing being applied to this element. It's all on the outer one. And we'll just refresh the page again. Entering targeting mode. Now, if you want to switch between elements, you want to target a different element, you can, of course, scroll through the source code. But if you have something that's like multiple layers deep, it's going to be hard to find the exact element, especially if it's off the page. So you can scroll to it in the document and just right click again and go inspect. And it'll take you to the elements. But there's also a handy trick where you can enter what's basically a targeting mode. And this is a really nifty feature. You just click this icon here. And now when you scroll over any elements, it goes right to it. You can see it's moving in the inspector to highlight that exact element. And then if we click the elements, it moves to it in blue. And also, I'll go back in targeting mode again. We can see some really useful information without having to click through the panels. If you hover over an element in targeting mode, we can see that this is an H3 element. We can see the color, the font size, and font families being rendered. We can also see the spacing properties, the margin that's being applied to this element. So if you're just trying to find something simple like the font size or the color or font family of an element, you have to go clicking through this computer tab over here. So that will save you a bit of time when you're just maybe looking at another website and you're trying to see what styles they're using. Now, we're not limited to the existing HTML of the document. We can actually edit it in real time. So you can right click on this element and you can choose to edit as HTML. You can also hide an element, but it'll stay in the HTML document, or you can delete it altogether. And that will remove it entirely. You can also just double click on any elements. You could change the tag, so we can make that an H2. And we could even add a class or ID. So we could say class equals my heading or something. You hit enter to save. And now we could target our selector by that rule. So for example, I could just I'll go to the style tab, hit the plus icon here. And it automatically inserted this selector, H2, that is class my heading. You can hit tab to go to between the brackets where you can start writing your rules. And I could just say font size 66 pixels. And we'll just refresh to clear that. Next up, we can actually toggle the state of an element. And this is useful when you're doing anything that has a hover effect, for example. So if we were just to inspect this link over here, you wouldn't actually see the color that's applied when you hover it, which is this light blue color. And you can keep scrolling and it's not at the top. But what you actually want to do is you want to click this toggle element state button. And then now we can select the hover state. And we can see the hover effect that's being applied to this element. So we'll put into the hover state. You can see that it's now changed to that lighter blue and it's underlined. And the hover rules, all the rules that are targeting that hover state have now been moved to the top of the style tab. So it makes it really easy to tweak this. We could just change this to make it red, we can make it a solid border, whatever. Now, one thing to note is that if you change the existing styles for existing selectors that are already in the style tab, these changes won't appear in your inspector style sheet. So if we were to create a new rule, we'll just say font weight bold. The rule that we created that's new goes into the inspector style sheet, but you can see that the other modifications we made do not. So if you do know that you want to be copying these styles to reuse elsewhere or to save them for later use, you want to make sure you create a new rule instead of modifying existing rules. Another really handy feature that is underused, in my opinion, is this responsive view. And you can put it in responsive mode. And let me dock the toolbar to the side so you can see it a bit better. But you can actually choose from predefined devices that will show their exact screen size. You can preview your layout on smaller screens, or you can use responsive mode that lets you drag the width of the browser window so you can see how your layout shifts as the screen size changes. And this is really good for handling issues that might pop up on smaller screens to make sure your layout looks good across the full range of screen sizes. And to get out of responsive mode, you can just click right here to exit again. Now, so far, we've just scratched the surface of what you can do with Chrome DevTools. And if you'd like to dig deeper into some of the more advanced features like speed profiling, or learn how to reverse engineer components from other websites and recreate them for your own designs, let me know in the comments below and maybe I'll do a video on it. And if you have any other video suggestions, please let me know because I'm always looking for good ideas for future tutorials. Now, if you're ready to keep building, check out this video right over here and I will see you in the next one.